Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Shreya Savitre. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 7th of May. At least 10 killed in gas leak incident in southern India. Pakistanis struggle with inflation and lockdown during Ramadan. And police force falls victim to coronavirus in Bangladesh. And now for all the details. At least 10 people were killed in South India by a gas leak at a South Korean-owned factory making polystyrene products. Emergency services rushed over 300 people to hospitals and evacuated thousands.
A chemical gas leak at LG Polymers plant owned by a South Korean company in Visakhapatnam city of India's southern Andhra Pradesh province killed at least 10 people and made hundreds of people sick on Thursday. People affected by the poisonous gas were immediately rushed to hospital and hundreds of people from nearby areas were also evacuated to stop the further spread. Chemical styrene leaked from the plant during the early hours of Thursday morning, when families in the surrounding villages were asleep, officials said. The plant had been reopened in the past few days after India relaxed a nationwide lockdown imposed on March 24 to contain coronavirus spread.
Overall, I think about 800 to 1,000 people have gone to the hospital and they have been taken care of. So now the focus is not so much on the gas leakage as the effects of the gas leakage and the treatment of the people who have been affected.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi also held a meeting on Thursday with officials of the Interior Ministry and disaster management authorities to take stock of the situation and assured all assistance.
India's Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan has said the country's COVID-19 mortality rate is the lowest in the world at 3.3%, while recovery rate has been increasing. The COVID-19 cases tally crossed 52,000 mark on Thursday.
As India on Thursday reported 52,952 coronavirus cases with 1,783 fatalities, Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan said India's COVID-19 mortality rate was the lowest in the world at 3.3%. While holding a virtual review meeting on the coronavirus situation, the health minister highlighted the recovery rate has also increased to 28.2% in the country as 15,266 people have recovered from the infection so far. Harshvardhan said India has also begun clinical trials of its age-old medicinal practice of Ayurveda in addition to the existing standard care given for COVID-19 patients.
हमारा सारे दुनिया के मुकाबले सबसे कम फैटेलिटी रेट है 3.3% और रिकवरी रेट आप सब इतने दिनों से देख रहे हैं कि वो दिन प्रतिदिन बेहतर होता जाता है आज की तारीख में 28.8% है.
Meanwhile, an amphibious warship of the Indian Navy arrived in Maldivian capital Male on Thursday to bring back 1,000 Indian citizens who have been stranded in the island nation. The Indian government has also sent 64 repatriation flights for a week from May 7 as part of the massive evacuation plan to bring around 15,000 Indian nationals from 12 countries.
Moving on. People in Pakistan are struggling with both inflation and coronavirus lockdown during the Islamic holy month of Ramadan. The country has already been facing an economic crisis and stocking up for the month has been hard, especially for those relying on a day-to-day income.
People across Pakistan are marking the Islamic fasting month of Ramadan under a lockdown imposed to stem the spread of the coronavirus. But with the country facing an economic crisis as well, stocking up for the month has been hard for many, especially for those who rely on a day-to-day income. Ramadan may be a month of fasting, but for many Muslims, it also involves a gastronomical feast. However, spiraling food prices, which are a regular feature during the Islamic holy month, has made life difficult for the poor and middle class alike.
भाई महंगाई तो बहुत ज़्यादा हो चुकी है और गरीब आदमी सबसे ज़्यादा परेशान है. अब तो खैर मिडिल तबका भी तक परेशान हो गया, खासतौर से लॉकडाउन के हवाले से. और किसी को गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से कोई भी किसी किस्म की कोई माली इमदाद नहीं है, कोई पैकेज नहीं है, कुछ भी देन सिर्फ ऐलानात की हद तक है, कह रहे हैं मगर मिला किसी को भी कुछ नहीं है.
Amid the lockdown, only shops selling essentials are open, and people who rely on labor work are struggling hard to make ends meet as businesses are shut.
सारी बंद है, कारोबार सब बंद है. मजदूरी होगी तो जेब में कुछ होगा, खाएंगे पिएंगे भी, अपने घर पे भी देंगे. अब तो आप लोग कहाँ पे जाएं? हमारे वजीर आजम साहब हैं, वो बोलते हैं भाई लॉकडाउन कर लो, बंद कर दो सब कुछ. उनके तो अकाउंट में भरे हुए हैं, हमारे अब जेब में तो खाली, हम गरीब हम कहाँ पे जाएं?
Even before lockdown, the South Asian nation had been struggling to keep its economy afloat with a balance of payment crisis. As of Thursday, Pakistan recorded over 23,690 confirmed cases of COVID-19, with more than 540 deaths.
U.S. Special Envoy Zalmay Khalilzad met Taliban leader Mullah Abdul Ghani Baradar in Doha, aimed at speeding up efforts for intra-Afghan peace talks. The ambassador is also scheduled to meet Indian and Pakistani officials for support in Afghan peace process.
U.S. Special Envoy Zalmay Khalilzad met with the Taliban's deputy leader Mullah Abdul Ghani Baradar in Qatar and discussed the prisoner release, intra-Afghan talks and the U.S.-Taliban peace agreement. A Taliban spokesperson confirmed on Wednesday. Khalilzad and Baradar signed a peace agreement on February 29 in Doha. The U.S.-Taliban deal called for the Taliban to release up to 1,000 government prisoners and for the Afghan government to free up to 5,000 Taliban prisoners before the peace talks that were to begin on March 10. But a dispute over the pace and the scale of the releases between the militants and the government, which was not a party to the deal, resulted in the delay in the talks. The Taliban has also increased their attacks recently in the country. Meanwhile, the U.S. State Department on Wednesday also informed that Khalilzad is scheduled to visit India and Pakistan after his Qatar visit to discuss the important role of New Delhi and Islamabad for sustainable Afghan peace.
Nepal in the latest has reported a two-month infant among those infected by COVID-19. The country has extended its nationwide lockdown till May 18th, citing the rise in coronavirus patients.
Nepal in the latest on Thursday reported 99 confirmed cases of novel coronavirus after 17 new cases of COVID-19 were detected on Wednesday. The new cases in Nepal's Parsa district include a two-month-old infant, said Dr. Vikas Dev Kota, spokesperson for Nepal's health ministry. With the new cases, the number of COVID-19 cases has reached 24 in Parsa alone. Of the total cases in the Himalayan nation so far, 19 people have recovered and no one has succumbed to the disease. There were also reports that three patients who were discharged after they tested negative for COVID-19 again tested positive during follow-up tests, raising concerns among health experts. Nepal government on Wednesday extended the nationwide lockdown until May 18 in view of the rising number of coronavirus cases, saying the threat is not over yet. Nepal has been under lockdown since March 24.
In news from Bangladesh, six members of police force have reportedly died in Bangladesh after being infected by coronavirus, with thousands more infected. Six police members have died in Bangladesh after being infected by novel coronavirus, with thousands more infected, according to the Dhaka Metropolitan Police. Members of the police force have played a variety of roles during the lockdown in the country, including transporting people to hospital and inspecting markets. As of Wednesday, 1,190 members were receiving treatment at the Central Police Hospital in Dhaka. Around 1,260 are in quarantine at home, with another 1,089 in isolation.
When we inform that corona is spreading, then we prepare our plan how we can protect our police members as well as the mass people. Till today, total 6 police members already died due to the corona infection.
Local media reports suggested the police have promised to pay $12,000 to the families of any members that die from the coronavirus, in addition to other government remuneration. Bangladesh, which is under a nationwide lockdown, reported over 12,400 cases of the virus with 186 deaths on Thursday. A mechanic in northeast India's Agartala town has created a bike which has about 1 meter of distance between its two seats. Running on electric power, the bike has been created to make people aware about the need of social distancing in the time of coronavirus pandemic.
Indian mechanic Partha Saha from a remote town in northeast India's Tripura province has created what he calls a social distancing bike. Running on electric power, the bike has a distance of about 1 meter between the two seats. Saha created the bike for merely around $396.
Abhi COVID-19 ka jo problem chal raha hai, isse bachne ka ek hi tarika hai ki aap social distancing ko maintain kijiye. तो जैसा कि हमारी गवर्नमेंट भी अभी बोल रहा है कि इस लॉकडाउन के टाइम आप घर में रहिए, तो अगर आपको किसी तरह से घर से बाहर निकलना ही है तो आप कैसे निकल सकते हैं, इसका मैसेज मैंने इस बाइक में दिया है।
साहा सेज ही पार्ट द बाइक इंजन विद इलेक्ट्रिसिटी टू आल्सो गिव अ मैसेज ऑफ क्लीन एनवायरनमेंट। इंडिया रिलैक्स्ड कोरोना वायरस लॉकडाउन रूल्स ऑन May 4, बट आस्क द पब्लिक to maintain social distance to prevent the spread of the novel coronavirus. The tally of infections in India on Thursday crossed 52,000 mark with over 1,780 deaths.
Sikhism holiest shrine, the Golden Temple in northern India, was illuminated with earthen lamps on Wednesday to mark the 541st birth anniversary of the religion's third spiritual leader. The occasion, usually celebrated with huge religious fervor, was limited to staff and nearby residents amid coronavirus lockdown.
Sikhism's holiest shrine, the Golden Temple in Amritsar city of India's northern Punjab province, was illuminated with earthen lamps on Wednesday to mark the 541st birth anniversary of the religion's third spiritual leader, Guru Amar Das. Born in 1479, Guru Amar Das was a proponent of rights of the women and advocated equality between men and women. The occasion is observed with huge religious fervor every year, but this time the celebrations were limited to those who work at the Sikh shrine and only nearby residents due to coronavirus lockdown across India.
ਸੱਚਖੰਡ ਸ਼੍ਰੀ ਹਰਿਮੰਦਰ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਜੀ ਦੀਆਂ ਪਰਿਕਰਮਾ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਘਿਓ ਦੇ ਦੀਵਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਹੈ ਦੀਪਮਾਲਾ ਕੀਤੀ ਗਈ ਆ। ਇਸ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਨਾਲ ਗੁਰੂ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਅੱਗੇ ਸੱਚੇ ਪਾਤਸ਼ਾਹ ਅੱਗੇ ਅਰਦਾਸ ਕੀਤੀ ਗਈ ਹੈ। ਜਿਹੜੀ ਵਰਲਡ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਬਿਮਾਰੀ ਚੱਲ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ, ਮਹਾਂਮਾਰੀ ਚੱਲ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ ਕਰੋਨਾ ਵਾਇਰਸ ਦੀ, ਇਹਦੇ ਤੋਂ ਛੁਟਕਾਰੇ ਲਈ, ਜਿਹੜਾ ਸੁੱਖ ਸ਼ਾਂਤੀ ਪਹਿਲਾਂ ਵਰਗੇ ਦਿਨ ਲਿਆਉਣ ਲਈ ਗੁਰੂ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਅੱਗੇ ਅਰਦਾਸ ਕੀਤੀ। ਸੱਚੇ ਪਾਤਸ਼ਾਹ ਜੇਤੀ ਤੋਂ ਛੇਤੀ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਵਾ ਜੋ ਪਹਿਲੇ ਵਰਗੇ ਦਿਨ ਲਿਆਏ।
India on May 4th entered its third phase of nationwide coronavirus lockdown with considerable relaxations. However, almost all religious places in the country remain closed for large public gatherings.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline. And follow us on Twitter at @SAsianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.